got claws! What does your future hold? It's payback time!
Problem solving to me, eh? You're in safe paws now.
So near, and yet so far. Hazard detected. Service suspended.
Enough of you!
Get ready! This one's for you!
I'm not just a fortune teller!
power. Generator on standby.
Don't mention it. All in a day's work.
Generator. Lockdown protocol engaged. Insufficient LOCO. Administer accelerant to red generator. levels increasing. Additional accelerants required to meet operational standard. Levels confirmed. Generator online. Lockdown protocol disengaged.
Future's looking bright.
sufficient power.
Sounds about right.
Switching ventilation system to maintenance mode, enabling duct access. Please commence on-site inspection.
According to this, that generator's somewhere upstairs. Well, nothing else for it. Back into the air duct I go.
Sure you'll be okay?
Positive. I'll be in and out before you know it. Don't have too much fun without me.
to get the thing open first.
Stroke of luck! I'm not just a fortune teller!
Boxes ought to do the trick. Now, let's see.
Yeah!
elevator operation. Additional cargo required. Operation. Additional cargo required. Sufficient cargo weight confirmed. Commence transfer of cargo from loading bay to proceed.
Better for a wee lie down. So then, onwards and upwards?
Please wait.
For crying out loud! What is it this time?
You'll require the password to proceed.
Go again.
Now, no need for violence. I come in peace, and to abet your escape as well.
Like hell you do.
Really, it's true. You're far more resilient than anticipated. And I concluded that, rather than allow you to run amok any longer, I ought to help you see yourselves out peacefully. The password is comprised of 4 2-digit numbers. I wrote them down in this very room, but where? Well then, no time to waste. suppose. To any unauthorized personnel. It's where I've been keeping a rather unruly figure.
Yeah.
Come on now, don't be shy.
Wasn't he built for this kind of thing?
Excellent work dispatching that scene. Thanks to you, the manor is a little more neat and tidy. All well-earned praise aside, since that nettlesome test subject is finally out of my hair, I have no further reason to remain here. It's been nothing if not entertaining. Until we meet again. Exterminators.
That smug asshole. Next time I see him, I'm ramming my fist right through his face. Agreed.
Agreed.
We best get going. The terminal's waiting.
Well, look who the cat dragged in. Hey there.
So, find that terminal?
Let's just say we got a little sidetracked.
Well, we can but try again. No sense stewing on past mistakes.
Right.
Thank you.
than me. The core's a bit grim, no?
Doesn't matter. Who are you?
Vincent Valentine. I'm... security. Why are you here? Be brief.
Your terminal.
Keycard. The authorization, at least.
Oh, great.
Though you're clearly not Murasaki, explain yourself.
It's a bit of a long story, and we'd love to tell you all about it, but there's something we really need to look up first. Can't go letting a foe win the information war, eh?
Your foe? And who might that be?
A man who many people, myself included, once called a hero. Sephiroth. He's insane, and he's after something so powerful, it could destroy the planet unless we stop him.
I see. Then I have one more sin to atone for. The room is unlocked. Use it as you see fit. Mr. Murasaki.
Don't mind if we do, I guess.
There she is! Cloud, my boy! Still got that keycard. Gonna need a bit of time with this. Might you suggest a spot of recon?
Huh? What's wrong?
Nearly. There.
Here. Oh no!
I don't recall giving you permission to go in there.
Oh, it was an honest mistake. We didn't mean any... Ah! Don't hurt me! Please! I can explain!
Drop it.
Why should I? He's trespassing, like you.
Save it. I've had a pretty shit day.
What a coincidence. So have I.
Your thing.
I know your story. Vincent Valentine, former Turk. Stumbled on your file in the company database. There's a reason you're alone in the dark down here. And that reason has something to do with Sephiroth. Am I right?
That's none of your business.
I only ask because you might want to come with us. I don't know whether Sephiroth is dead or alive or something in between. But I do know that if I stick with this lot, I'll find out one way or another. Is this how you want your story to end? Your way out, then. Now we know where the temple is, let's not bother the man.
Hey, Space Cadet. Come on.
Is that all you ever think about?
Well, excuse me for trying to be helpful.
Hear that, Black Materia? I'm coming for you! Oh man, my rep's gonna go through the roof!
Well, it ain't like it could go down. Oh, it's on.
So, where is it?
Aye,
about that.
What's the matter? You ain't been bluffing this whole time, have you?
No, that's not it. We could go there right now if you really wanted. But before that, would you mind a quick trip to the saucer?
What? Why would we want to go there?
To even set foot inside the temple, we'll need to get our hands on a relic called the Keystone. Trouble is, it's been missing for nigh on 20 years. So, any guesses as to where it was last seen?
The gold saucer.
I know, it's a stretch, no denying that. But it's the only lead I've got.
Then let's follow it. We trust you.
You do? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, if we gotta. Once we're good, let's get a move on.
Right.
What's this?
Misunderstand. I'm defying my boss to be here, because I've got a hunger that cannot be denied.
Cloud, bring me the Black Materia.
My desire to see you has driven me on. That's what I get for redlining the old engine. All right, my friend, it's the final lap. So let's con it one last time!
He's mine!
No. Come on.
Break yourself!
No more playing nice. You're out of luck. You okay?
I won't have your pity. This is a race, remember? Come on, Cloud. We're on the home stretch! Degradation. My friend.
To you. Don't worry.
Yeah, she's right. You're gonna be just fine.
Come on. The Gilded Saucer awaits. And the Keystone.
Yeah.
Shinra Resistance Committee. My name is Glenn Lodbrok, a representative of Wutai's interim government. War is upon us, when we must rise up to confront tyranny. Mere days ago, Junon's cannon rang out. A message. A declaration by Shinra's new president that he, like his father before him, would rule by fear. What's more, we recently learned that he had sanctioned the development of living weapons grown within the Mako reactors that provide power to your homes. Alarmed, we decided to seek answers, and in accordance with the ceasefire treaty, our government sent officials to investigate. Shinra promised their full cooperation. But when our inspectors duly arrived, they were mercilessly slaughtered. The footage you are about to see was taken from inside one of the reactors. This is what Rufus Shinra calls a ceasefire. Friends, we do not have our enemy's military might. Nevertheless, A righteous fury burns in each of our hearts. A fire that we may carry to Midgar. And there, together, put the city of Mako and Misery to the torch. This is our answer, Rufus Shinra. We are ready to march. And to lead us, Wu Tai's commander, Viceroy Saru.
Who exactly is this Saruf? The Invisible Man?
Regrettably, we have no intelligence to present at this time.
Then you clearly aren't looking hard enough. Look harder.
Ma'am.
What about that Glenn... what's his name?
Glenn Lodbrok, ma'am. Ex-soldier. P-Zero class, a prototype. 15 years ago, he was sent to Redor on a geological survey, which ended in failure and led to his defection.
A spineless deserter nursing a grudge, then.
Subsequently, Lodbrok took to the road, seeking to forge connections with others who shared his anti-Shinra sentiments.
If you mean Avalanche, they're dead and buried.
I'm afraid I do not, sir. The fall of the Republic triggered a spate of uprisings in the surrounding regions. We suspect the SRC is largely comprised of forces who were defeated during the unrest.
Well, who could blame them? They fought against the Republic in the name of freedom. But when the smoke finally cleared, they found themselves under the heel of a new oppressor. Why, I'd be more surprised if they didn't hate us.
Pity about Saruf. Would be good to put a face to the name.
The Ancient is en route to the temple as we speak. Pursuing her is our top priority. She will guide us to the promised land. One way or another.
Regarding the speech, sir, many will interpret it as a declaration of war. And given that it was a worldwide broadcast, it would be prudent to issue a response.
I intend to make a statement. Sung, if you would.
Sir.
So, how exactly are we supposed to get back to the saucer?
With all the mountains and valleys in between, definitely not on foot. It's just way too far. Thoughts, Kateseth?
Hey, Cat! Thoughts?
Huh? Well, you see...
Look, smoke! Maybe someone's trying to call for Cid? If so, let's hitch a ride.
Breaking news at this hour. Breaking news at this hour. In response to last night's illegal broadcast by the SRC, President Shinra held an emergency press conference this morning. In it, the President denounced the SRC's claim for baseless propaganda. Broadcast by the SRC, President Rufus Shinra held an emergency press conference this morning. In it, the President denounced the SRC's claims as baseless propaganda and dismissed their alleged Mako reactor footage as a digital fabrication. The company has launched an investigation into the individual who delivered the address, as well as the nature of the organization he claims to represent. Breaking news at this hour.
Stood up?
Nope. Waiting on you folks. Something I wanted to ask. About your mother. Her name's Ifalna, right?
Maybe. So what?
That sounds like a yes to me.
I called it the second I saw you.
Boy, am I ever glad I sent up smoke. Tell me, how's she doing? Good?
No. She's dead.
You know, the whole reason I joined Shinra was to become a pilot. But I wound up as a gopher for some lazy grease monkeys. Had me running around HQ, fixing lights and whatnot. One time, though, I came across a pretty young thing with a little girl in her arms. That was you, wasn't it?
Probably.
You were knee-high to a Tonberry. And I was what? Calls a smogger, I'd wager. Truly. Hey, Missy.
It's Aerith.
Aerith, is there anything I can do for you? I want to help.
What? Why?
Just trying to do right by you.
Flying us around will be more than plenty. Thanks.
Then again, if you're just dying to help, you could take us to the saucer for free.
Free?
It's fine. We'll pay.
Now, it's on me. When you want to head to the saucer, just give me a holler. Hey, good to go? Let's get a move on, then. An 8?
You said that Sephiroth is your foe. I have a history with him. Unfinished business.
He bothering you? Want me to give him the boot?
Try to screw us over, and you're a dead man.
Please, take a seat.
Do you think you can manage 8?
Ain't gonna lie. That's a tall order for most pilots. Lucky for you, I ain't most pilots. Swim away from!
You almost killed us!
Okay, let's start her up. Sounds good.
Yeah, but the wings are still broken.
And? What of it? Only one man has mastered the land, air, and sea. You're looking at it. You got that?
Okay, so?
So, you can think of me as the captain of your ship. Strap on in and we'll punch through the chop.
Aye, aye.
Let's set sail. Straight through the ravine and on to Costa del Sol. And after that,
we hit it.
Sounds like a plan. We'll be there before you know it.
Let's set a course for Costa del Sol, sir.
Roger that. Full speed ahead.
Hey, mind filling us in on the Keystone before we arrive?
Gladly. About 20 years back, one of our more eccentric colleagues convinced the company to build a museum of his antiques. The Reliquary, they called it. Pretty cool, eh? Now, according to the company records, the Keystone was housed there.
Wait a second. I thought you said it was at the Gold Saucer.
Aye, I'm getting to that. In a threat. It wasn't. Oh, right. So, the museum was about to get totally wrong. Closed as soon as it opened. But somewhere between cutting the ribbon and boarding up the windows, the Keystone vanished into thin air.
So it's not at the saucer?
Do you know where it went?
No, but I know a man who might. The former Curie.
Deal.
Hmm? How do you know that name?
Let's just say, I've been around a while.
After the museum debacle, all Deal was devoted, only to be promoted again when the saucer took off. Made director in no time. Real riches to rags to riches story. All of which is why we're bound for the saucer.
Hey, Sid, did I hear right? You used to work with Shinra.
Still do, on occasion. The boys got their uses.
That's gonna be a problem. You see, we don't take kindly to friends of the company.
And I don't take kindly to that tone of yours. Man who tries to lord his power over me is gonna wish he didn't. That's what's appealing about the skies. Got them all to myself. Rats can have their race in the gutter. Never much cared for the squeaking anyways. I miss the wild blue yonder dearly.
I hope Johnny's all healed up by now.
And that his hotel's found its, ceiling.
Bad chance. Kid probably got gripped again and was crying himself to sleep every night.
Thank you for choosing Bronco Cruises. We sincerely hope you enjoyed your trip with us.
Cruises? I thought it was Bronco Airlines.
Not after his wings got clipped.
Seriously, we really appreciate you ferrying us around.
You're most welcome. Hey, y'all are headed to the saucer, ain't you? I might could tag along, take in the splendor. What do you think?
Of course.
Earl always knows just what to say. Am I right? Shall we?
Wait a sec. Where's Vincent?
Up there.
Another loner. As if one wasn't enough of a pain in my ass.
Yeah, one's more than enough. You mean me?
Ha
way. Hey, Cloud, let me see that. This reeks of sea salt, and not the fresh kind either. This thing smells ancient.
Really?
Yeah. Gramps told me about it. Long ago, when most folks spent their lives at sea, a war broke out between some pirates. I mean, how do you think they came up with Pirate's Rampage? It's based on a true story. How about it? Want to hear?
Yeah. Why not?
Gather round and hearken to my tale. Before steel birds soared through the skies and tracks wove across the land, wooden ships were the primary means of travel. One such ship was crewed not by men, but monsters, hellions of the high seas. From the fires of war, these pirates emerged victorious, leaving crimson waters in their wake. The world's oceans now his sole dominion. The captain was declared the Pirate King. As for the king's treasure, ere his passing, he took his most prized possession, quartered it, and sealed those pieces away, along with his four finest mates, to forever stand guard. Whatever he hid, this map should point us to the locations in which its fragments rest. The spell he used to seal them away seems to have broken as well. For the Pirate King's treasure is now ours to seek. Four ferocious fiends yet stand in our way. Doubtless, they'll put up quite a fight.
And I, for one, can't wait!
We're the only pair here.
Try all our exciting and mysterious flavors.
Let the paint flow along the wall in a gentle breeze.
Should split up to look for Dio.
Will do!
If I catch you goofing off, so help me out.
Cloud? You got a minute? There's something I failed to mention about the Temple of the Ancients. You might call it a legend or a warning.
Uh-huh.
You see, no one who goes into the temple ever comes out again. No one. And I'm wondering if you really want to take everyone to a place like that.
You said it yourself. It's just a legend.
I did, aye. But
let's focus on finding Dio and the Keystone for now.
Thank you.
Check it out, Cloud. Can you believe this?
Corneo?
The Dawn outstayed his welcome in Midgar and decided to set up shop in the Saucer. Great timing, eh? Interesting. There's an event being held at the Musclehead Coliseum tomorrow.
If there's a dress rehearsal today, Dio might be there. We should check it out.
I bought some protein powder.
Is spectating not
enough? Musclehead Coliseum will host it.
Head to our...
Found him. Greetings, Mr. Director. He doesn't look quite right.
Well, if it isn't our friendly fugitives, you're looking hale and hearty.
What happened to you?
I made a painful discovery. That the Turks are stronger than they look.
You, sir, should know better. You're no spring chicken. Speaking of old things, whatever happened to that wee keystone thingy?
We need to get our hands on it. It was part of your collection, last we heard.
It was, yes. And in fact, still is.
Point of order, my ancestors owned it. Don't you think that makes me its rightful owner?
A Cetra, are you? That, my dear, is a bold claim. But still, who am I to dispute your heritage? You may, of course, have the keystone. That is, on one condition. Take part in our exclusive event, the Fight for Naming Rights! Dio's champions versus the Corneo family! Should my team fall to those rogues, the Gold Saucer will become Corneo Land! Let's sit out! Training hard and getting those games?
What's up, party people?
What's up?
It's a challenge from the dark!
Sign and
normalize! Give the people what they want! Take it! Entertain!
But look at me. I can barely lift a finger. And here I was, lamenting my lot in life, when you came along! 'Tis fate. Nay, divine intervention! What say you? Will you be my champions and go to war against Don Corneo?
I'll do it. I'll fight.
We win, we get the keystone. Right?
As agreed. You have my word.
Then we're in.
Then we have ourselves a deal. Naturally, I want you in peak physical condition for the big bout, so please use my hotel to rest up.
Great! I'll jog on ahead and tell the others then.
Coliseum. You'd better rest up before your big day. Best of luck to you tomorrow.
A songwriting?
Oh, I'm not. But I wanted to give it a shot.
I see. Well, good for you. Never know till you try.
They say curiosity killed the cat.
Here. Cloud's all yours. I'll take care of Aerith after.
Yes, ma'am. Sure does sleep a lot, huh?
It's better this way.
What? Why?
Because of Cloud. He's still sick. Please, you gotta make Cloud get better. You gotta.
I mean, I'd love to, but... You, You said it's better for Aerith to stay asleep because Cloud's sick. Why's that?
Because she'll die if she wakes up.
Oh, you think? What makes you say that?
Promise not to tell? When she wakes up, a scary man is gonna kill her.
Huh?
Cloud tries to save her, but he doesn't make it in time. He almost does, but he doesn't. She likes Cloud, so she's happy he came. Really, really happy. But she dies. That's why you have to make Cloud better. If he's sick, he can't save Aerith.
Marlene, are you sure you didn't just have a bad dream?
No. I saw it.
Oh, okay.
I did!
Don't worry, I believe you. With everything that's going on, how could I not?
Okay.
Just one question, if it's all right. Can you tell me what the scary man looked like? Please?
His hair was long. And gray.
Of all the people.
Zack, did you see? They're blooming.
Would you look at that?
These were always Aerith's favorites. Do you think this means she's going to wake up?
Maybe. Can always hope. Hey, Elmira. I've got to go away for a bit. Need to talk to someone about Cloud.
And who is this someone? A doctor?
Well, he's, Close enough, I suppose.
Well, hurry on back, okay? It's hard enough looking after these two with your help, but without it... Without you, I'd be a wreck.
Don't worry, I'm going by bike. Shouldn't take long. Just keep an eye on him while I'm gone, okay? Oh, and if Aerith does wake up, please don't let her leave.
No promises. That girl snuck out more times than I can count.
Don't let her. Please.
I won't.
I thought about what you said. Couldn't stop thinking about it, actually.
about how it's up to each of us
to find our own purpose in life. Because in Avalanche, I think I've found mine. We don't have a whole lot of time. So tonight's gotta be the night. Do yourself a favor and steer clear of Reactor 6. Take care, Biggs.
No, I didn't. That's not what I meant! Gotta find Elmira.
Those off?
No.
Those pillow marks say different.
Yeah. You got me.
Anyway, wanna broaden your artistic horizons? Loveless is playing here. And I got us tickets.
Sure.
After that, we could ride the Skywheel.
Right. We missed out on that before.
Yeah, but not this time. Let's go.
Thank you.